Hi guys, it's Crystal with Design Bundles. Today I want to teach you guys how to use the templates that Cricut has provided for us to use in Cricut Design Space. So these two templates are to use with their new mug press, and I'm going to show you how to use them. The first one here is going to be for a wrap. If you are using infusible ink, or if you wanted to wrap your mug, or you know, add an image or anything like that. The next one is going to be if you want to draw an image to add on your mug. So let's go ahead and start with the wrap mug first. We're going to click on it here. The first thing that you want to do is come to where it says finish sizes, and you want to choose your size. So you have a 12 ounce or a 15 ounce. And then you also want to choose your edge. Do you want a straight, ripped, scalloped, wavy, or even a zigzag edge? Let's go ahead and stick with the straight edge 12 ounce. So we're going to go ahead and click that now. And we're going to hit customize. There is three layers to this template. Now keep in mind, this is a template, so it's very similar to the templates that are right over here. It's going to guide you and help you design your product. So you have three layers. Number one, you have the red layer, which is these mugs here. You can see the little lines here. It's just going to help you with your placement. But once we get done with our project and we're ready to make it, you want to make sure you hit the eye right over here to get rid of it, because we're not going to cut that piece out. It's just to help guide you. The second layer, this is your infusible ink layer or your wrap layer. So this layer right here, just visualize if you were using infusible ink, whether it be a paint splatter, a plaid, or you know, an outer space pattern. You're going to do a knockout with your design on this layer. So this is your infusible ink layer. Like I said, visualize that this is your infusible ink. The third layer is, this is the material that is wrapped on your infusible ink. So if you've ever used infusible ink, you know that it comes with a mask very similar to HTV. So what it's going to do when this cuts out, it's going to cut all the way down into the plastic. So that way it leaves us with an edge on each side that becomes the tape. It's going to help hold it onto the mug, which is really, really cool. So that is what the third layer is. So let's go ahead and play around with it. So first up, let's pretend that we're doing an infusible ink. So this is our infusible ink layer. I'm going to come over here, upload an image. I'm going to choose this one right here, insert image. I'm going to go ahead and size this down and figure out about where I want it to be. So what I'm doing is I'm visualizing in between these mugs and this little line here. I'm just going to line that up where I want it. Maybe I want to shrink it down a little bit. So I'm just keeping it nice and straight in there. So the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to come over here and hide this white layer, because you notice there was a layer back there. And then the next thing I'm going to do is click my design again, and I'm going to hit weld. So that way it's now one image. So you notice you've seen that whole side shrink up, and it's one image right here. The next thing I want to do is I'm going to select this layer as well as my infusible ink layer, and I'm going to hit slice. So now what we can do is we can get rid of, on the right hand side, you can see that I'm clicking on the design and I'm going to hit delete. I'm also going to click on the blue one and hit delete. So now you can see I have a knockout. So it's knocked out my infusible ink. All right, so now this file is ready to go. All we have to do is hide the red layer by hitting the eye right over here. And this one is completely ready to go. So when we cut this out, it's going to cut out this design on the infusible ink, and we're going to be able to wrap it onto the mug. All right, so let's go ahead and do another one. For the next one, I'm actually going to do a sublimation. So I'm going to do a print and cut. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to come to upload, and I'm going to find my pattern. So this is going to be my pattern for the mug. I'm going to hit insert images, and I'm going to start to size this down. So what I need to do is I need to make this the same height as our infusible ink layer, our wrap layer, if you will. So I know that this layer is 3.79 high. So I'm going to click back on this one, and I'm going to change the height to 3.79. So now what I'm going to do is you can either kind of line this up here like so. If you want to make sure it's nice and straight, you can simply select this layer, hit shift, select the mug wrap layer, and we're going to hit slice. So now we're going to delete this piece right here. So now we have our wrap layer. So this is ready for a print and cut. So what you can do is hide this piece right over here. Then I'm going to come back. So I can definitely just do a print and cut with this one. So what I would actually want to do is, since I'm just using infusible ink, I would hide this layer as well as the red layer. So all I have to do now is hit make it. And it's my print and cut layer, and that's all it's going to do, and it's going to be the perfect size. So what I would actually end up doing is just using a heat resistant tape. Now let's go ahead and go back in here and let's add a design. So if I wanted to, I could actually add more to it before I did so. I'm going to hit insert image, but I'm actually going to come over here and I'm going to undo the red, and I'm going to undo the wrap piece just so I can visually see everything again. So I'm going to click on my design. I'm going to bring it down wherever I want it, however big I want it. And then I'm going to actually hit weld so it's all one color, and I'm going to change it to black. Just like so. So I'm going to size it out just a little bit more. There we go. So now I have this super cute design on top of my layer here. So what I want to do is I actually want it on both sides of the mug. I want it on the left side of the mug as well as the right side of the mug. I'm going to hit duplicate. And I will actually line that up. Now, if I want to make sure that these are going to be nice and even on my mug, so what I would do is I'm going to select this one, hit shift, select the other one, and I'm going to hit align. So I'm going to go ahead and hit align top, just like so. So now I know that those are going to be completely straight across. The next thing I need to do is I need to attach it to my wrap layer. So I'm going to select my wrap layer, hit shift, and select these two right here. And hit attach. So now when I go to hit make it, I'm gonna go ahead and hide everything else and hit make it. We're gonna have a nice print and cut layer. So we've got our, it's all gonna stay attached. So when we wrap our mug with this, it's gonna be nicely lined up where it needs to be, and it's gonna be perfect. So there is, if you were using infusible ink as well as sublimation. Now with this one, let's just say I don't want a layer and I'm not using infusible ink and I don't need a layer. Let's start with upload. Let's go ahead and use one of my favorite designs, which is this super cute bunny right now. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to size this down and I'm going to start with 3.6. There we go. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to get rid of this layer right here. I'm going to hide it because I'm not doing a wrap. So I'm going to size this down to wherever I want it, however big I want it. And now I'm just making sure it's nice and straight with these mugs and this line here. So I'm just going to line that up like so. So if I want this design on the left side of my mug, I would obviously put it on the left side, right? Because think about this wrap coming around and wrapping to the handle. So if I hold that left handle, you're going to be able to see this on the front. If I want it on the right, I'm going to place it on the right. So if I hold the mug with my right hand, I want it on this side. Or if you would like it in the center, you could definitely have it in the very center of your mug as well. So what another thing is, I'm going to duplicate it once again. I can have it on both sides. Or maybe I want to have, let's come back to upload. Maybe we want to have Boss Babe on one side and the bunny on the other. You can definitely do two different images like so. The next thing I would do is I would select this one and I would hit align and hit vertical and I would hit attach. So that way, whenever I go over here, I'm going to go ahead and hit the red layer here, hide it, hide that bottom one. I'm going to go to make it. And there it is. There's our print and cut layer. So that's how you're going to use this one for sublimation and infusible ink. Now let's go ahead and go check out the next template. Next up is your draw mug template. So this one is going to be perfect for the infusible ink pens. So what we're going to do is click that here and hit customize. Once again, you're going to choose whether you're using a small 12 ounce or a 15 ounce. We're going to choose 12 ounce and hit customize. Now this one here has two layers. You once again have the red layer, which is for lining up our image. This layer right here is going to be our copy paper layer. So what we want to do is come to upload. I'm going to bring in my design, insert. Now this is going to come in really, really big. First thing I'm going to do is I'm going to hit weld and I'm going to bring it down to, once again, 3.6. Enter. I'm going to come over here to the basic cut and I'm going to change it to pin. I'm going to change it to a pin draw. So same thing, I'm going to line this up just like we did before with the other one. And that's it. The only thing that we needed to do is delete this layer or hide it with the eye over there. Once again, I want to make sure that this is welded so that way it is one small image. I want to go ahead and attach it to our paper. I've got it lined up where I want it. I've gotten rid of the red piece. I want to go ahead and hit select all and hit attach. That way they stay on the same place. So I know that this is going to cut out all the way around this. It's going to stay right where I need it to be. So we're going to hit make it. And that's what it's going to look like on your mat. Now, remember, you do need to hit mirror, because we are working with infusible ink. So definitely make sure when you're working with your sublimation designs, your infusible ink, and all of those, that you guys mirror those so that way they go on there correctly. And that's it. That's how easy it is to use the two templates from Cricut using your own designs for sublimation or using them with infusible ink or even with the infusible pens. So I hope you guys enjoyed this. I hope you found it helpful. If you did, please hit the like button down below, subscribe, and I'll see you on the next one.